Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. It had been way too long since I shopped on Nykaa, like really shopped on there. So they were having the end of season sale and I wanted to take full advantage of that, and I did. I was literally sitting there like a lion waiting for its prey, for like Nykaa to go live. And the moment it went live, I literally pranced on the opportunity and ordered whatever I could. So yes, this is going to be my Nykaa haul. So if you want to know what I got, just keep on watching. And I promise you that there are some really exciting bits in there. By the way, the look that I'm currently wearing is using all the products that I ordered in this haul. And it will be up after this video goes up. So don't forget to check the video. I'm gonna start with the last step first. This is the Maybelline Lasting Fix Makeup Setting Spray. This is in the matte finish. I saw a few makeup and beauty bloggers talking about this. I don't really remember if they loved it or not, but I wanted to purchase this, and it comes in this cute pinkish purple. I don't know the exact name of this color, but this packaging is cute and I liked it, so I got it. And I needed like a new setting spray anyway, because I only have MAC Fix Plus. Not that I am any eager to replace it, because I think I will keep buying MAC Fix Plus until I'm putting on makeup. That is the absolute love of my life and nothing can replace it. Okay, then I have these four brushes from PAC. I've already used them because I used them to do this makeup look that I have on right now. So the first brush is the Pro Arte PE29. Is it Pro Art or Pro Arte? I really don't know. It's a very pointed brush. You can use it to blend your lower lash line, or like I used it to really define your crease, even for inner corner highlight or putting highlight here. Then I have the Pro Art PE23 brush, and this is your usual smaller blending brush, but I actually really loved this for a semi-precise blend. If you know, you know what I mean by that. You don't always need like a really large fluffy blending brush. It gets the eyeshadow everywhere, especially if you have small eyes like me. That is why I really wanted to get this one. And all of these brushes are so like inexpensive. At first I kind of was dismissing them because of the price. I thought they were not gonna be of the best quality, but I was so wrong, because I used these brushes, the ones in the haul today, for the first time, and I think I'm in love. And I got this AE26 brush from Pro Art, and this is, they describe this as a cream eyeshadow brush, but really you can use it for anything. It's like a flat brush, but a really like precise flat brush. I have this Pro Art PE30 fine liner brush. I did not use this. Let me take it out of the packaging and show it to you. All of these Pro Art brushes are actually, they feel sturdy and good quality. I cannot believe the price that they sell it for, because these seem so good. I feel like you don't have to buy Morphe brushes, because on them you gotta pay duties and you gotta pay shipping. But with these, I feel like they are the same price range, if not cheaper. And I get it that Morphe probably has more brush options, but they have all the ones we really need, okay? We don't need a new brush set, in my opinion, every single day. So this is the fine liner brush. Very, very little. It's actually very fine. Can you even see it? I think it's going to be amazing. You're gonna get some really precise lines with this. Wow. I have two foundations. One is the NYX Can't Stop Won't Stop foundation. This is in the shade medium olive. I used it today and this is the finish of it on my face. I did not set it, and I have combination skin that's more towards the oily end. I think that says a lot about this. And also, I did not use any concealer on my skin whatsoever. I only used this foundation, and if you saw the before of my face, before I put on this foundation, I had so many blemishes and little spots on my face. You will see that in the video once I upload it. L'Oreal Fresh Wear Infallible 24 Hour Fresh Wear Foundation. I heard so many like OG YouTubers and OG beauty bloggers and the biggest names talk so highly about this foundation. Some of them even said that they will choose this over a lot of their high-end foundation, and if not choose this, it compared to their high-end foundations, which is saying a lot. That was enough for me to want this, but unfortunately I think I've gotten a shade too light for me. If you compare this with the NYX one, it's definitely light. So I haven't opened it. I think I'm gonna return this if that is possible and get my shade. I really hope I'm able to return it because I have waited 1,000 years to try this, okay? 1,000 years, literally. Let's talk lip liners because I ordered two and both of these were recommended by Tati. I definitely trust her opinion so much. I'm wearing a combination of both of these on my lips plus Blush Velvet from Lakme. This one is a little bit of a lighter nude and I like a little bit of a darker nude on my lips. The formula was really good on this and the color, as you can see, is, I mean, it's cute. If you're my skin tone or lighter than me, it will look amazing on you, especially if you're lighter than me. I think that this will be your perfect nude. This is the Milani color statement lip liner in 04 All Natural, and this is the swatch of it. I have the Maybelline Color Sensational Lip Shaping Lip Liner in 115 Totally Toffee. I'm so excited because after all of these years, okay, I have found my perfect nude. Like, this is my perfect nude. Let me just swatch this for you. The formulation on this is epic, to say the least. This is what I had been looking for my entire life. Can you see how this is a little bit darker than the Milani one? This is exactly what I was talking about. But the Milani one is still great because on some days and with certain looks, you do want a lighter lip. You don't necessarily want a dark lip like this. And this will be amazing for people who are my skin tone or darker than me. And then I have this NYX eyeshadow primer. This is in skin tone. Kind of reminds me of MAC Painterly Paint Pot. It's very thin. I used it today on my eyelids and I think it definitely helped bring out the color of my eyeshadow. And here it is, the item that I was personally the most excited about. This is the Physicians Formula Spotlight Illuminating Primer. It is so glowy. Be prepared, guys. Be prepared. I'm gonna take just one pump of this. And don't be fooled, this is not a small amount, because just a little bit of this primer goes a long way. Can you see that? This covered my entire face today and I have this on underneath this makeup. I got the Maybelline Lash Sensational Waterproof Mascara. This is nothing new. I'm wearing this on my eyelashes today and I've been buying this for years and years and years. Just in case you haven't tried it, this is how the wand of it looks. It kind of has like a little curve like here on the bottom. Can you see that? You guys already know I love my glow, so I had to get a liquid highlighter. This is the Maybelline Master Strobing liquid highlighter. This is in the shade nude and here is the swatch of it coming right up. It's not super glowy, but it's doable. If you like a really natural, subtle glow, this one is definitely for you. Doesn't look like it has much shimmer in it. Even if it does, it's literally extremely small, but it's still got that glow and I think that is all that matters. So I got another foundation. This is from Makeup Revolution. I don't know the exact name of this foundation, but basically this is this thick foundation. And this is in the shade F14. It is definitely too dark for my skin tone. Let me swatch it on for you. So I bought this for contouring and this is extremely pigmented. I love it. I used it and it blends easily. If you really want to see my first impressions, definitely check out that video. It will be up after this video. And if you're watching in the future, I will link it in the description. I also got this hairbrush. It came in a box like this and it's from Roots. So basically, I have a lot of flyaways on top of my head and I have a lot of baby hair along my hairline. I think something like this can really help with that. I've seen other people do it. I also accidentally discovered it. I throw on a little bit of a hairspray, some gel or whatever you want to use, and yeah, your flyaways will be there no more. And the opposite side of the comb is of course amazing to part, like really straight lines. Then I got two products from Cocoon. I actually got this from their website, not from Nykaa, but I thought I'll just throw them in there because these are also available on Nykaa. I bought the Cocoon Hydrating Night Serum with Vitamin C and yada yada yada. I heard this from Jovita George and I think Shreya Jain, and they were raving so much about this, so I had to check it out and that is why I bought it. The Cocoon website was basically having a buy one get one free, and since I was going to get that face serum anyway, I thought I'll pick up a free product. This is the protective hair serum with argan oil and vitamin E. So it has heat protection, anti-fizz, conditions and detangles, and these are exactly all the four things that I needed. I will link these along with all the items that I've mentioned in the video in the description box below, and it's so easy to literally click on that link, click add to cart, click checkout, and with three clicks you're done. So definitely check out the links in my description box. Wow, I can't talk, I've filmed so much today. But yeah, check out the description box for links to all the products and yeah, get shopping. And with that, we come to an end for today's video. I really hope you guys enjoyed watching this. Don't forget to wait for the next video, which will be me trying out all of these products. Thank you so, so much for watching and I will see you in my next video, guys. Don't forget to like the video and subscribe to my channel. Bye, guys.